गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। क्लास फोर, टेक आउट योर सोशल स्टडी बुक, ओपन योर बुक्स, कम टू द पेज नंबर 40। इट्स अवर 16 लेक्चर, सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डू रीडिंग। आवर लेसन नेम इज द कमिंग ऑफ इस्लाम टू सिंध। The subcontinent, as you know, has been invaded many times by people from different areas. They brought their cultures, values, and religions with them, with the result that this area come under the influence of many religions. It was not until AD 712 that it was exposed to a relatively new religion, that was Islam. AD 712 is an important year in the history of our region. By that time, sea trade had developed between India and Arabia. Sometimes the ships were attacked by pirates along the coast. Ships carrying precious gifts from Sri Lanka for Hajjaj bin Yusuf, the governor of Iraq, were looted by the pirates near the port of Debel on the coast of Sindh. When news of this attack reached Hajjaj, he demanded that Dahir return the Muslim captives and the looted items. Hajjaj then sent Muhammad bin Qasim to fight the pirates and release the ships. Muhammad bin Qasim successfully defeated the pirates and later brought the whole area of Sindh and parts of the Punjab as far as Multan under his control. This remained as Arab territory for the next 300 years. He also brought Islam to the area and the faith spread throughout Sindh and the Punjab. Students, come to the next page, page number 41. Results of the coming of Islam to Sindh. The coming of Islam to Sindh. First result is a fair system of laws was introduced, which had no caste system. Natives adopted the Arabic script. The area enjoyed a period of peace. Mosques were built and Islam spread. Pirates were defeated and trade increased with Southeast Asia and China through Arab ports, and Hindus were treated kindly.